A number of people have asked me, why are you having a book party for Jack Abramoff? Are you a close old friend of Jack's? And I said, I've actually known Jack for a long time, haven't been close friends with him for a long time, and I'm doing it for two reasons, both of which are completely heartfelt. And the first is that I think Jack is a genuinely nice person. Whatever you have read or seen, and I think that the book will give evidence of this, there's a decency that emanates from him. Despite all other accounts, I've experienced it personally, and I think it's real. I'm willing to vouch for that. So I'm impressed by anybody in Washington who exudes that level of kindness to other people. And the other reason is, just as a matter of personal philosophy, I don't trust anyone who hasn't been humiliated in public. And I mean that. And I say, yes! And I say that as someone who's been on Dancing with the Stars, but more than that, I say that as someone who's philosophically committed to the truth that unless you fail, and I don't mean in a minor, like I didn't live up to my personal expectations today kind of way, but in a real way, where your neighbors avert their gaze when you pull into your driveway at night, when people think you're a loser. If you haven't had that experience, then you really don't know yourself very well, and you don't know your limits. You don't know what you're capable of, and more important, you don't know what you're not capable of. People who have been through that, and Jack has, understand something about the world that those who haven't do not. And I respect that, and I want to honor that, especially in a city that is given to quick and phony judgments about other people. The underlying point being, I'm better than him. Mm-hmm. I raise a middle finger to those people. I raise a glass to Jack Abramoff, and I'm proud to do so. So,
cheers. 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 Cheers.
Thank you, Tucker. Susie, thank you for opening your home and being an incredible friend. I've known Tucker for a long time. I know his father back in the Reagan days. And it's been a long time since those days. Sometimes I wish those days were still here. And what happened since didn't happen, but it did happen. And I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart, not just for having a party, but for standing up and being a real friend, and for the various responses you gave in the media. They were quite heartening to us. I think that a lot of the people who had different views were quite disturbed by it, at least I got to hear so I'm very grateful to book out, and I'm trying to show people that I don't have a tail and horns, and I'm not Satan.
Middle name is Hannibal.
Right, that's a Hannibal Lecter, as she lovingly calls me. And of course, my family, who's here, my wife Pam, and my daughter Sarah and Olivia. My sons are not here tonight. Two of my sons are on the West Coast, where they work and go to school, and one of our sons is on the East Coast. We've been through a lot. I have to tell you, this has not been a lot of fun. And I said, Pam is going to be upset at me because I'm going to laud her. And when I was writing the book, I said, well, you know, I'm writing it up, and she said, well, could you just do me a favor, just don't mention me. Well, I'm writing Pam, I'm writing my autobiography. I don't leave out that I married you for 25 years. Where do the kids come from? People aren't interested in me. I'm a housewife, and people don't really care about me, and I'm not really political. And I said, well, even if that's true, what am I going to look like if I basically just skip over you? So Pam, who was a communications major in college, was one of the people who edited the book. And when she first started editing the book, I would get back the copy, and she'd be removed. All right. Just kind of playing with the mood, and somehow children arrived in the text. Anyway, I fought to put it back in, but I said on the radio today, fortunately Pam doesn't listen to the radio, read newspapers, watch television. After all this started, she canceled our subscriptions to the Washington Times and the Washington Post, barely sneaked the Wall Street Journal into the house without her stopping me. But I said, and I mean on the radio, that it's not merely that I married above myself, and it's not merely that my wife and partner has been loyal in a place where, frankly, you know, where I lived for 3.5 years, 80% of the men had their wives leave them as soon as they enter that place, the prison. And it's a horrific place. It's unimaginable. I hope nobody in this room has had to endure it. But I was fortunate, and I am fortunate, to have a wife who not only stood by me and came to visit me each of the 185 weekends that I spent in that facility, but also bucks me up, you know, because believe it or not, sometimes this gets depressing, you know, when you see your picture on the front page of the Post a little too often, or once, my life has taken a bit of a turn. I used to be a right-wing guy who, sort of disdained the New York Times, 60 Minutes, and Michael Moore. And now I'm happy to be on 60 Minutes. I love the pieces in the New York Times, and Michael Moore's my new best friend. He grabs my hand and says, look, I can't, I saw your 60 Minutes, I'm looking at your book. It's wonderful, God bless you, keep up the good work, I support you, it's fantastic. I must be dreaming here, but I guess even I and Michael Moore can agree on certain things, and that's basically that hopefully there'll be some changes or at least some discussion about some of the things that are in the book. I'm grateful to you all. Tucker and Susie, I can't thank you enough for having this party here and for doing this. This is the finest night of our lives. Certainly in at least the last 8 years. even the night, we were happy that I finally walked out of the prison, which was a great night. This is really tops them all, and I'm very grateful to you. Thank you all.